Hey guys, it's Corte with another deck profile. This is my Nubatama Legion deck. This is the starter Stealth Beast Kuroko. She is a very awesome starter. When you boost with her, the attack hits the Vanguard. I pretty much put her behind Vanguard each and every time just to increase chances. Basically, Soul Blast 1, when the attack hits the Vanguard, Soul Blast 1, and destroy up to 2 bound cards. So you can get rid of a lot of cards that way. And granted, it gives fuel for legioning if they do run legion or what have you. If you're playing, strange enough, if you're playing against ground blue, then it may not work in your favor unless, you know, you can manage to get them great locked somehow at 1. So anyway, grade 3s. I run 4 of the Break Ride, Shura Stealth Dragon, Kuji Kitty Kongo. It's still a great card. Not mandatory, but still a great card nonetheless. Limit Break 4. So when you ride him, he gives your Vanguard plus 10, and your opponent has to discard a card of their choosing and bind the card face down from hand of their choosing. Again, not mandatory to have, but very good to have, you know. So, you don't have to have less cards in hand than your opponent, like this deck is known for. The new Legion is a promo. It came with the Paladins that came out. So, if you know anybody with Paladins, you might want to go, you know, kiss ass if you have to. this is the Legion Shura Stealth Dragon Mandora Kongo. You counterblast 1, discard a copy of himself or the mate. There's the mate right here. This is what they look like together. Anyway, you discard a copy of him or the mate, and if your opponent has 4 more cards, so you really want to pay attention to how many cards your opponent has in his or her hand. Counterblast 1, pay the cost, and bind 2 cards from their hand face down, and a card on the field face up on their side. So you just got rid of 5 cards with the Break Ride skill if you manage to wait that long. So yeah, with Kuroko, you're really going to need to run either, you know, 3, maybe 3, you know, so you can continue to get that off, but if you don't want to, you still got around 4 of the backup card, Shura Stealth Dragon, Dorani Kongo. He's the pretty much grade 2 version of your starter. When you're in Legion, he's an 11k attacker. So that's first off, a really good effect. And again, like the starter, Soul Blast 1 and make your opponent discard up to 2 cards in the bind zone of your choosing. So again, Break Ride, Legion effect, that's 5 cards, and then you can get rid of almost all of their cards with if this attack hits the Vanguard and the Vanguard hits the Vanguard. So that's, you know, all 4 cards just gone. So and if you're backed up with Kuroko and him, then your opponent's definitely going to try to PG him because they don't want to get rid of cards. But if they PG him, then they can't PG your Vanguard. So anyway, Tomahagane, Stealth Beast Tomahagane, he is on ride or call, and you bind the card face up on the field, free of cost. So he's a very good ride target. And very good rear target. So if you want to go ahead and intercept with him, put him back into the deck, and have his effect go off again, really good. Oboro Zakura, he is the 10k vanilla. I run 1 of him. Only run 9 grade 2s because my zeros are insane. anyway, grade 1s. I run 4 Stealth Dragon Dreadmaster. There's a reason he's called Dreadmaster, because your opponent will dread seeing him boosting anything. Because if you have less cards in your hand than your opponent does, and you boost and you attack anything, and it hits, counterblast 1, your opponent discards a card of their choosing. So you always want him on rear guard, behind one of your rear guards, like the new Legion mate. So not only are you discarding a card, but you're forcing them to, you know, guard extra heavy because they don't want their bound cards to go and they don't want to discard a card. So it's very scary how the combos pop off. Three of the PG. I run three Tempest, Stealth, Rogue, Fuki. You could run them at four, but this deck is really counterblast heavy. Being that the new three costs a counterblast, he costs a counterblast, and one of the zeros I run costs a counterblast. I'll get to that in a second. His effect is you play him on rear guard, counterblast one, put him into the soul. Your opponent has three or more cards in hand. So right at the beginning of the match, you can start off with his effect. Later on, when you have the counterblast and you really, really want to piss off your opponent and you want to hoard him and, you know, play him, counterblast into the soul, play him, counterblast into the soul till they have little to no cards in hand. But again, you have to watch how many cards they have in hand because of the Legion, four or more, or his effect, three or more. And then three of the 8K vanilla grade zeros. This is the zero I was mentioning earlier. This is Hagakure. You place him on rear, Guardian Circle when you're defending, and your opponent has to discard a card if you have less cards than they do. So I used to run him at four, and four was a fantastic number, and I always had great defense, and almost always had more cards than my opponent. But again, if you hoard him, and or Fuki, they both almost do the exact same thing, except for one's when you're defending and one's when you're about to go on the offense. So, four draw trigger. I still run four. This deck runs off of you having less cards than your opponent. But if you have less cards than your opponent almost too often running, they have to where you can run eight crit. Four stand, four heal, which is great for offensive purposes, but if you're only drawing, you know, three cards a turn, which is not great, especially with Stride out now, and you will have no real way to actually get to your twos and threes for your Legion's effect. So, I run four of the draw trigger. This is more soul fodder. The stand trigger, you put it into your soul and give something plus three, and you pop it out with a soul blast if the attack hits, of course. Four heal trigger, and to wind things down, for the new trigger, Tobihiko. He looks really awesome. They really stuck with a lot of wolf, things that really have great effects. Be it Hagakure, Tobihiko, the perfect guard. You know, the wolves are the ones that you really want to go to, and they all look really awesome. Except he looks more like a coyote, but it's whatever. Anyway, comment, rate, subscribe, check out my other videos, and if you guys have any questions, comments, leave them in the comments section. I'll get back to you ASAP.